This video discusses the usage of message queues in Unix. Message queues and mailboxes are software engineering components used for inter-process communication, IPC, or for inter-thread communication within the same process. They provide a mean or a method of indirect communication. The communication is asynchronous. This means that the sender and receiver of the message do not need to interact with the message queue at the same time. Messages placed onto the queue are stored until the recipient retrieved them. Message queues allow us to send a block of data from one process to another. Each block of data has a unit type, and a receiving process may receive blocks of data having different typed values independently. We can use message queues to synchronize events between processes. I found some images on the internet that explain this principle. Here's one. This shows a message queue data structure. A message queue has many different IDs, and each ID is associated with a queue. The sender will put the messages into the queue. The messages has a data structure and the message tag. So each block of data can be defined, can be specified in a certain way, and the receiver will retrieve messages from the queue. Now here's another one that shows some simple code of using message queues in Unix. This is the code segment for the sender, and this is for the receiver. So we have to define the data structure, the same data structure for sender and receiver. So we have a data type, okay, and then a buffer to hold the text. And we use the system call msg-get to get a unique message ID. And to use this system call, we have to give a key, and then specifying what we want to do. Here we want to create a message ID, and with this key value 100, we get an ID, message ID. So the receiver also use the same key, so that means it will get the same message ID. So they will refer to the same message queue. So the sender first, just very simple, copy a message onto the buffer and text, and then use the system call msg-send to send the message to the message queue associated with this MSG ID. Okay, the maximum length is 512. Zero means we have to read at the beginning, and so we send to the queue associated with the ID, and the receiver use MSG RCV to retrieve the message associated with the message ID, and then it prints that out. It turns out that actually some other processes can also enter data block into the queue, and some other processes can delete messages from the queue, but they have to use the same key to specify the same queue or to generate the same message ID. Now, I have some simple examples on using the message queue. So here's the sender, so we include all these headers, okay, and define data structure. So this is the buffer that holds the message. And we develop variable running and use a buffer to hold the text. Again, first we use the system call msg_get to get a message ID. We use the key 1234. The receiver has to use the same key. And while running, we will ask for some text. And then we copy the text to the buffer of the message queue block, data block. And then use msg_send to send the message in the buffer to the message queue. If the buffer is end, then we set running to zero, then we exit this loop. So this is the sender, and we can compile it. So compiles. Now this is the receiver. That is very similar to the sender, except that now we use this system called msg_rcv to receive the message from the message queue, and then we print out the message. And if the message is n, then we also set running to zero, then we exit this while loop. And this msgctl with this IPC RMID means to clear the queue. And again, we can compile that using msg1. So it compiles. Now, we can start the sender and receiver. As we discussed earlier, the communication is asynchronous. That means they do not need to be on at the same time. So I can first turn on MSG to the sender and enter a message. So the hello, CSE460. Enter. So that has been paged into message queue. So the receiver has not been even active. Now I turn on the receiver MSG1. So you can see that it retrieved the message from the from message queue. So now let's put another message. You can see that this appears in the receiver immediately, and we can type n to n. Okay, so both terminates. Now, if you want to know the details of those functions, you can type mand msg_send. That tells you the details of the msg_send function, and also the system called msg_rcv. So you can study that in more detail. Now I have another example that is just modify that MSG 1 and 2 slightly. This MSG RS that can be used to send and receive. So to do that, we declare two message ID. One, the key is 2345. The other message ID is 1234. And so this will ask for some text. Okay. and we set the message type to be 1. And so we put the text, copy the text from the buffer where we have entered to the message buffer, some text, and then send it to the message queue associated with MSG ID 2. Okay, so we send the data. And if it is end, then we terminate. Otherwise, we print waiting for receiving. Now we receive from an other message queue, MSG ID, okay, that uses a different key. Okay, so that means this is for receiving, this is for sending. Okay. And at the end, we remove the message queue and awakening or waiting reader and writer processes using the MSG CTL. Using this flagged RMID. And another one used correspondingly MSG RS1.cpp. So again, this is 1234 MSG ID. For it, this is the receive. And MSG ID 2345. For this process, it is to send. So you can see that again, it use MSG 2 to send the data, and use MSG ID to receive the data. So you can see it, how this works. So I have compiled them already. So I can say the MSG RS2 hello 460. Okay. So now it's waiting, and this is MSG RS1. So you can see that it has received this from the message queue. And now it can send some data. Democracy is nice. And again, so this has been sent to the other side, okay. And we can say end, and so it ends, okay, both of them. Okay. So this is how message queues work, and you can study them. Okay. Thank you, bye bye.